we are here at the grand opening of the Otay Compost Facility. It's the first one of its kind where it's entirely run on solar power. It's really a compost facility off the grid, which is totally cool.
By the end of the year, we'll have 200 tons per day capacity for green waste, and green waste mixed with food waste.
So this facility will be critically important to the region's infrastructure for processing organic materials.
We knew that we have to comply with SB 1383, so coordination with Republic started years ago. When organic waste gets just buried in a landfill, it creates methane, very harmful greenhouse gas. Finding a good solution for it, like creating compost, which will help sequester carbon and improve the soil health, it's again incredibly important for us.
To help them to comply with the 1383 requirements, all of their food waste and green waste is going to be coming to this facility.
So this is just a snapshot of what came in this morning. It gets ground, then as we add all the feedstock on top, put the cover over it. You know, the covers are keeping the water out, but it's also keeping the moisture as well as the odors in. You know, I can look on here, is the air on, is it off, what's the oxygen, what's the temperature in that pile? All of that helps speed up the compost process.
And instead of those harmful materials being placed into landfill, they actually will be turned into valuable products that help increase our climate resilience. By adding compost and mulch to the soil, we increase its ability to hold water, so soil temperatures will be buffered, and it'll also provide that soil fertility that we need.
Across California, because unfortunately some of the fires, the catastrophes, the droughts, I think more and more people are understanding that climate change is real. And I think now with facilities like this, people like me and you and everyone in California can actually do something about it. It is a team effort. It takes a village to do this. All of the city council meetings and board of supervisor meetings we've been at, you know, it's been really powerful to hear elected officials really understanding and committing to addressing climate change in this way. Recycling organic waste into new products is a fast track to combating climate change. Republic Services has been a leader in managing organic waste.
They're bringing the organic products kind of out of the waste stream into a circular, recyclable waste stream is really important to us.
This facility and program will help create green, high-tech jobs in our community.
This is a circular economy when we take from the material food waste over here being made into soil and other products that then can go back into our economy. That's what being circular is all about.
You know, I'm already thinking through an expansion.
So there's many new facilities that are being proposed and that are going through the permitting process, and we're looking forward to more facilities coming online soon.
You know, by recycling organic waste, paper, cardboard, food waste, green waste, we can have an immediate impact on battling climate change. And I think that's really empowering to know that I can actually do something about it and I can actually realize the benefits of it in my lifetime.